Weatherman says it is 81, but feels a little cooler than that because of the breeze that we've got going on, such as it is. And we are underway, and the kickoff will be taken back at the one-yard line by the Choctaw deep man. Along the far sideline, it's Mikhail Franklin with room to run. And the crowd roars as he gets out to the 40-yard line to start this drive. And so on offense for Mississippi College, up front, it's Frank Bean, Levi Lott, Hayden Calhoun, Cannon McCulley, and Garrett Franklin. The receivers are V. Williams and Javier Batiste. The running backs to start, Marcus Williams, Ron Creighton, and R.J. Wilson. And getting the start at quarterback for Mississippi College is the redshirt freshman, John Henry White. Line of scrimmage is going to be the 40-yard line. MC moving left to right to start this ball game. First and 10 for the Choctaws. And before the ball can be snapped, we've got movement on the line. Let's see.
Looked like as R.J. Wilson went into motion, the West Georgia defensive line jumped, thinking that the play had already started.
That's Demetrius Lofton, the defensive lineman, guilty of the penalty there. So it's be first and 5 for Mississippi College. Uncharacteristically, the Choctaws, 70 yards per ball game in penalties. West Georgia, however, 51. That's very uncharacteristic for them. First and 5. And this is going to be a running play on first down. And Ron Creighton gets the call, and it's a 4-yard gain to make it second down and 1. Creighton, the junior, third-year man out of Oak Grove, Louisiana. 186 rushing yards and a long TD coming into this ballgame. Second down, 1. Wideouts left and right. Creighton again is the fullback. Double wing back set. White goes up under center and fakes the handoff, or does he give it off? He does give it off. And once again, it is Creighton. And he's got the first down to the 48-yard line of West Georgia.
And that's something I've noticed with John Henry White running this offense. It fooled you there. He's very good at selling it as if he's still got the ball after the give to the fullback. But I mean, better than most quarterbacks I've seen running this style offense.
So a first down pickup for MC as we're just underway in the ball game. No score from the 48-yard line of West Georgia. Ball on the far side hash mark. White takes the snap. This time it's an option back left side to R.J. Wilson, and Wilson's out to the 43. Defensively for the University of West Georgia, up front 4, Keandre Williams, Eric Williams, Demetrius Lofton, and Mason Huntley. The linebackers are 2, Amos Dawn and Xavier Robinson. The corners are Cameron Figgins and Jalen Lee, and the safeties are Michael Merriweather, Ben Fortson, and Deontay Overstreet. 6-yard run there by R.J. Wilson, and it's second down and 4. And this is Creighton barreling forward for the first down to the 32-yard line. So Ron Creighton to the 37, and that'll be a first down pickup for Mississippi College with 2 minutes gone by in the ball game. So far, MC moving the ball well against this Wolves defense, giving up 350 yards per ball game and only 133 on the ground. Should be a pretty good test. First and 10 for MC. Again, wideouts are left and right. Creighton is the fullback. Williams in motion. And this is going to be Creighton yet again. This time he's out to the 34, and he gets 4 yards. Second down at about 6 coming up for Mississippi College. Choctaws coming off a game that they should have won, or at least could have won. They had chances to win it against Midwestern State last weekend. 30-17 was the final. And again, the issue in that game was the defense couldn't stay off the field in the second half, and there were too many mistakes in the first half. Second down, 6. John Henry White rolls out. He's going to pitch it at the last minute to Marcus Williams. Williams stood up at the 32-yard line. Good pursuit that time by the West Georgia defense. Mason Huntley, the defensive end out of Lilburn, Georgia, makes the stop.
And a really nice hit there just to stand up Williams. He tried to get some yardage after that first contact, but he was stonewalled.
So third down, 5 coming up. Gain of only 1 yard on that play. White directing traffic in the backfield. We'll send him down. He's got 10 on the play clock here. Third down, 5.
Shotgun formation.
Seen a lot of that this season. And this time it's a pitch back, and it is going to be R.J. Wilson. And Wilson with another strong run. He's in the red zone, out of bounds around the 17. And that'll be a Choctaw first down. You know, one of the things that we really haven't talked about a lot this year is we know Marcus Williams is a good running back. We know Ron Creighton can run. If you have R.J. Wilson emerge as a third option, that just keeps the defense further on their toes.
Absolutely. Wilson's looked really good running the ball thus far this season. And we even saw a pretty quiet game from Marcus Williams the other night. And Wilson took a little bit more of a lead role as the tailback.
From the 17-and-a-half-yard line, it's Creighton breaking a tackle. He's inside the 10 and down all the way to the 6-yard line before he's brought down by the West Georgia tackler, Jalen Miller.
Nice move by Creighton also to get out of a tackle as Overstreet looked like he had him before Creighton stopped and cut.
So a first down pickup for the Choctaws there at the West Georgia 7-yard line. Wideouts left and right. Creighton is the fullback, and they'll give it to him. And Ron is down to the 5. So second down goal to go from there.
Looks like they might mark him all the way back at the 6.
So a little bit closer to the goal line. Second down goal to go from there. 10 minutes to play in the first quarter. No score in the ball game. Choctaws taking their opening drive all the way into the red zone. Looks second like down, goal to go.
Looks like we're about to see shotgun once again from the Choctaws.
And this is going to be a handoff. Nope. It's going to be an option right side, and it is a touchdown for the Choctaws. R.J. Wilson.
And he's been a huge part of the offense on this first drive. Had 21 yards before that carry. And really good to see just another speedy back in this offense.
A very efficient opening drive for Mississippi College. And on an attempt the extra point for MC.
The right bank, it just fits with online and mobile tools that give you the freedom to do more. The power to make your dream home yours. And help your business stay on top. Technology that makes one bank fit you to a T. Trustmark, people you trust, advice that works.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests and our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best. Every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
There was a time when a person's word was enough. A time when a handshake meant something and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways. What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live.
9:40 to play in the first quarter. It's R.J. Wilson on the touchdown run at the end of that drive. Ten plays, 60 yards on the opening drive for MC. And now we'll get a first look at this West Georgia offense. And we'll see, will it be Ben Whitlock or Cameron Brown at starting quarterback for the Wolves? Pledger's kickoff taken at the 1 yard line by the deep back LaParian Perry, and he is a tough one, and he is stuffed and stuffed hard just shy of the 20 yard line. Let's see, on the special teams tackle for MC is Justin Ephebra. Yeah. He had a couple of good tackles against Midwestern State last week.
And LaParian's a really talented returner. We saw him have some good ones last season, only averaging about 17 yards per return this year, but he's somebody that can definitely hurt you. One of their better wide receivers as well.
So West Georgia will start at their own 19-yard line. And it'll be Cameron Brown starting at quarterback for West Georgia. He'll take the snap, turn one way, throw the other. Pass is caught. Couple of blocks there, and out to the 30-yard line goes Zay Britt, a junior from Oxford, Alabama. That's 11 yards and a first down pickup. West Georgia on offense. Up front, it's Brevin Jones, Marvin James, David Bodden, Austin Donaldson, and Brandon Pippen. Terrell Cole, Zay Britt, and LaParian Perry are the featured receivers. And Rajaz Mosley, along with Trey Williams, in the backfield. And Cameron Brown at quarterback in place of Ben Whitlock. And this second play from scrimmage is going to be a handoff to Mosley out across the 30 to the 35-yard line.
And I hate to jump on the officials this early in the game.
No, however, you don't. No, you don't.
But either way, a pretty blatant hold was missed on that screen pass. Terrell Cole had a Choctaw defensive back just completely wrapped up.
5 yard pickup, second down five. We kid because we love. From the 35-yard line, two receivers to either side here for the Wolves. Brown from the shotgun fakes the handoff, being chased, rolls out, pass is caught, and the receiver drugged down back at the 44-yard line. That's David Brown on the tackle, and great pressure in the backfield of Ephebra again. Or is that Zach Hammond? I think it's 11. Zach Hammond. Hammond making the tackle. We'll give it to Choctaw defense here in just a moment. That's a first down pickup for West Georgia. 8 minutes to play in the first quarter. 7-0 MC is the score. Mosley, the running back in the backfield. And he's going to get the call. Stutter step, cut to the outside, being chased. He's out across the 50. He's got the first down out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Defensively for Mississippi College, up front, it's Deshaun Washington, Jalen Gibson, and Scott Burton. The linebackers are Kevin Smith, Jason Betts, and Zach Hammond. The corners are Jacoby Graves and Braxton Hall. And the safeties are Grant Watts, David Brown, and Nick Grady, who already has a couple of picks this season, including one for a touchdown last week. Now from the 41 of Mississippi College, first and 10 for the Wolves. Brown takes the snap, quick throw to the right hash mark. Pass is caught, and that's LaParian Perry. Perry's down to the 36, and that's a 6 yard pickup. Perry, a senior out of LaGrange, Georgia. That's his 10th catch of the year, second most in the Gulf South Conference this season.
Yet to have a touchdown receiving on the season.
Line of scrimmage is the 37. But he certainly is a threat to score. Second down and a long six here for the Wolves. And this is a pass near side. It's nearly a lateral, but it's incomplete. Intended for Mosley.
And that one was close.
Very close indeed, but an immediate incomplete pass signal from the referee on the near side. And it's third down and a long six. West Georgia at 45% on third downs this year. And the Choctaws holding them at 39%. Third down and a long six here for West Georgia. Lined again is the 31 for the Wolves. Mosley's the running back. Brown, the quarterback, takes the snap. Drops back, now pressured, flushed out right side with room to run as the first down. Across the 20, cuts to the near sideline. He's at the 10, he's gonna score. Touchdown, Wolves, on a quarterback scramble of 37 yards. Cameron Brown with his third touchdown of the season.
And the Choctaws brought pressure off the near edge, and they were able to seal off the far edge easily, and that's how he was able to escape out of the pocket, and then some really nice running from him into that second level to pick up his blocks and get in the end zone.
So a touchdown run by Cameron Brown, the redshirt freshman quarterback from Byron, Georgia. He had two passing touchdowns last week, now a rushing touchdown. And the point after from Brock Pellegrino is up and through. 6:26 to play in the first quarter. And we're all tied at 7. We'll take a timeout, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
There was a time when a person's word was enough. A time when a handshake meant something, and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways. What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live when they need us most. You deserve more. You deserve a promise.
The if in life, it's a world of possibilities. If you go for a night out with friends, if you can keep an eye on your money along the way, if you know you have overdraft protection with no fee transfers from savings, when you get a low balance alert, it's easier to say yes to fun. If that sounds good, try Regions Life Banking.
Stay ready for the if in life. Regions Bank embrace the if in life.
Seven-seven ball game now with 6:26 to play in the first quarter, and the West Georgia kickoff goes through the end zone. It'll be brought out. The Choctaws will start first and 10. Family weekend here at Mississippi College. Big crowd on hand. This is as big, I think, Charlie, as any crowd we had last season.
Absolutely. I think this is right up there with the Delta State game from last year, which was homecoming. And I think that's, you know, family weekend is partially responsible for that, but also this huge freshman class that the school's brought in, certainly bringing a little bit of an atmosphere to these games, a lot of fun.
1,020 new students here at Mississippi College this year. First and 10 for the Choctaws. Option comes near side. Williams drops it. Ball's on the turf, and the Wolves have it at the 30. You very rarely see Marcus Williams bobble a pitch. But he did there, and the Choctaws turned the ball over. They turned it over three times last week against Midwestern State, and there is turnover number one here tonight.
Yep, and we've seen the Jekyll and Hyde effect that this offense can sometimes have, where early in games they'll catch you off guard and just run the ball down your throat for an early touchdown, but then the mistakes come back and bite them in the butt, and it certainly did there.
So first and 10 for West Georgia, and they'll start at the Choctaw 28-yard line. Quarterback Brown back to pass, looking right sideline, and it is caught but out of bounds. That's a great catch along the far sideline by the West Georgia receiver. That's Javen West.
But great range shown by Trajan Anderson-Watts to get all the way across the field to make the hit and knock him out of bounds to prevent a complete pass.
So second down 10 coming up. Tied at 7. Choctaws turned the ball over on one play, and the Wolves have it. And now they're at the Choctaw 28-yard line. Second down 10. Two receivers left, two to the right. Ball on the near side hash mark. Wolves moving right to left. Brown takes the snap. Another toss right side. Catch is made, block is there. Out across the 20, maybe enough for the first down. On the catch is Terrell Cole. It is going to be where they spot the football at the 19. That's looks just like shy of the line of game. Third down one coming up. Choctaw pass defense so far this season has been excellent, allowing only 89 yards per game, but they're going to get really tested tonight. Here's Brown on a scramble. He slowed down to the backfield. He's going to get the first down. And unfortunately for the Choctaws, Deshaun Washington, who did a good job to get to him, couldn't wrap him up in the backfield, but they do limit him to just a couple of yards. It's going to be just enough, it looks like, to move the chains. He needed the 19. Well, I don't know.
Coach Bland signals fourth down on the far side, and it looks like they've marked him inches.
I really thought he got enough for the first down, but that's a good spot for MC.
And it was certainly close. There was a pile of Choctaw defenders on top of him. I guess they did bring him down before he got all the way across the 21.
So Washington slowed him down just enough, and it's fourth down and less than a yard. And Brown takes the snap. They'll hand it off, coming near side, and there's the first down across the 10 and out of bounds around the 7-yard line goes Mosley, and the Wolves pick up a fresh set of downs.
And so far in the early going, this Wolves offense has looked much quicker to get around the edges than the Choctaw defense has been to get to them. I wonder if they want to spread the linebackers out or at least try to stay more conscious of the edges in this run game.
So goal to go here for the Wolves at the 7-yard line. 7-7 game now with 4:26 and counting to play in the first quarter. Two receivers to the left and two to the right side. Three to the right side. Brown alone in the backfield. Man in motion. And now Brown takes the snap. And he will fake the handoff, end around himself. He leaps towards the goal line, and he got over. Touchdown, Wolves.
And it's going to be a celebration penalty against Brown, however, as he spiked the ball after diving into the end zone.
And the Wolves take a 13-7 lead. And you had it right there, Charlie. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Brown will be tacked on the kickoff, and that's his first of the game. And again, this comes after the Choctaw turnover. So Pellegrino on for the point after try. And the kick is up, and the kick is good. 4:05 to play in the first quarter. 14-7 West Georgia. We'll take a quick break. Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests and our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best. Every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
.405 to play here in the first quarter. West Georgia off a Choctaw turnover, leading Mississippi College now 14-7. We had a miserably hot summer here in central Mississippi. 28 days in Clinton straight without any rain, and three full weeks of 100-plus degree temperatures. But we picked the right night to have the first home game of the regular season.
Absolutely. It's a hot one today, but as the sun's gone down, this has turned into a great night for football.
And the kickoff from the 20 after the unsportsmanlike penalty, Choctaw should get pretty good field goal position. Return man from the 22, that's Marcus Williams, and Williams out to the 42-yard line. Well, if the Choctaws win this ball game, they will hand John Bland his 100th career victory. He had 7 at the University of the Cumberlands, including a national championship in the NAIA ranks, 5 in his 1 year as head coach at the University of Southern Arkansas, and 24 here at Mississippi College. They haven't come as frequently as they once had, as he has led this program from Division III to Division II. But he's sitting on 99 wins, and hopefully the Choctaws tonight can get him number 100. MC will start this drive at their own 41-yard line. And it is going to be a quarterback option keeper. And John Henry White to the 46-yard line before he is pushed back as a penalty marker flies in away from the football.
Looks like R.J. Wilson had his helmet taken off. I think this one is looking to be against West Georgia.
Last week, the Choctaws had 4 unsportsmanlike penalties called in the game against Midwestern State, all against them, all in the first half. And you got to believe that perhaps West Georgia, noticing that, maybe trying to instigate something here. You never know. We'll see what the official has to say. They may think, hey, these guys are vulnerable to mouthing off a little too hard. And it is going to be unsportsmanlike, or excuse me, a personal foul, I beg your pardon, against West Georgia. And they'll tack that on to the end of the run. So if you take the unsportsmanlike penalty on the touchdown and now the personal foul, that's 30 yards gifted by the Wolves to the Choctaws.
And the Choctaws are going to be all the way in on the Wolves' 39-yard line on this first down play.
First and 10 for MC inside West Georgia territory. 14-7 West Georgia, 3:44 and counting to play in the first. Creighton gets the call, bounces to the outside, and down to the 31 he goes.
Good work by Creighton to bounce off a couple of defenders, break a couple of tackles for a nice run.
It's a 7-yard pickup, and it's second down 3 for Ron, who comes over to the sideline and gets a break. Or does he? No, he's still out there. Mikhail Franklin will come on for Mississippi College. I see Thad Bishop. Is that Thad wearing number 14? I don't know about that. White up under center. He'll roll out near side, going to keep it himself across the 30 down to the 27-yard line.
I believe you saw Quavante Swanigan at 14, number 14 is a running back.
Okay.
Junior transfer from Pearl River.
Micah Thurman on the tackle there for West Georgia. And it's first and 10 for MC. Ball advanced to the 27. Wideouts left and right. Quarterback goes up under center, and he is hit from behind, and he lost the ball. The Wolves say they have fallen on it. There's a penalty marker on the far side of the field, too. This may be a motion penalty against MC. And if it is, it may have saved their bacon. Let's see what the referee tells us.
Coach Bland is signaling that it should be Choctaw ball.
Offside against West Georgia. Well, no wonder that defender got to John Henry White in such a hurry. I mean, he got him from behind before he had started to cut up field.
He got him from behind before he really could step back to even complete the fake to Creighton. Definitely makes sense now.
So a first and 5 upcoming here for Mississippi College. Line of scrimmage becomes the 22.
And another really, really costly penalty for the Wolves.
Nick Millsap in at running back for MC. They'll give it to him off left tackle inside the 20. He goes to the 18. Oh, my goodness.
We can't do that.
I didn't see a flag thrown, but I tell you what.
That's a small miracle.
Indeed, it is. That's Jeremy Smith, the safety for West Georgia. Or is that was that Franklin? I beg your pardon. It was 16 for the Choctaws. Mikhail Franklin got away with a shove.
I wonder if the reason they didn't throw the flag is if they're assuming or saw that there was some embellishment from the West Georgia player, because he certainly flew a few yards.
Second down and 1 for MC. Wide up under center. And they're going to go with the quarterback sneak. And he's pushed forward to near the 16. Fresh set of downs here for MC. Closing minutes of the first quarter, 14-7 West Georgia. Choctaws on the move. They're in the red zone again. So Mississippi College with a first and 10 from the West Georgia 16. Looking to tie the ball game on this drive. And John Henry hands it off to Creighton, and Creighton barrels forward inside the 10, stretches it out to the 8-yard line.
And I tell you what, I really love seeing the triple option run out of this shotgun set, because it spreads out the defense a little bit more, really opens up lanes for Ron Creighton. I think it just is kind of an evolution of the same principles of their kind of classic triple option offense.
And again, I think with the emergence of R.J. Wilson, that's three three options the Choctaws have in at running back. Second down, two now from about the 8-yard line. Quarterback keeper, and John Henry White is tackled very quickly in the backfield.
And we saw the penalty for an early start a couple plays ago from West Georgia. That time they timed it up
perfectly
as they were coming across the line just as soon as that ball was snapped.
Jeremy Smith on the tackle. We've got a timeout on the field. That's the end of the first quarter. It's West Georgia 14, Mississippi College 7 after 1. We'll take a timeout, and Choctaws football will continue in a moment. Reed Vance, Charlie Williams, Zach Sewell with you from Robinson-Hale Stadium here tonight as we start the second quarter. And West Georgia leading Mississippi College 14-7. But the Choctaws are in the red zone at the 10-yard line. Third down four for Mississippi College. And a new quarterback, Cam Davis, makes his first appearance of the night for MC. And he's going to stay in the pocket. Now he's going to run forward, and he's got to the 7. Really closer to the 8. That's not going to be enough for the first down.
He's just going to be a few inches short. I wouldn't be surprised to see them run that same QB sneak that they ran beforehand. As Ron Creighton's looking over to the sideline, motioning like he's shoveling food into his mouth, saying, feed me the ball.
Davis, 6'5", 215. At quarterback, and they're going to go for it. It's fourth down and a full yard and maybe just a hair more. He'll stay in the shotgun, though.
Looks like he's going to try to go hard offside.
And John Bland's going to call a timeout. Timeout, Choctaws. West Georgia leading at 14-7. We'll keep it right here. Before every home game, one lucky MC student will have a chance to punt, pass, and kick from one goal line to the other in the Chick-fil-A Punt, Pass, and Kick Challenge for a chance to win free Chick-fil-A for a year. Download the Chick-fil-A One app today to order, redeem points, and earn rewards with every purchase. Earlier today, Shorter defeated Chawan 57-20. Other games going on right now at the half. West Florida is leading. Check that. They are tied with Florida A&M 3-3. After two periods at halftime, Mississippi Valley State leads Delta State 7-6. Late first half, North Greenville 17, West Alabama 13. And at halftime, Valdosta State leading Kaiser 21-13.
That Kaiser team has been one that's kind of been a thorn in the side of both us and Valdosta State, given both programs close games in the last couple of years.
Fourth down and two for Mississippi College, really, more so than one. Fourth and two. Choctaw's going to line up to go for it here. John Henry White back in at quarterback. Ron Creighton to his left in the backfield. And they'll give it to Ron, and straight ahead he goes.
He's got it.
Look at that pile pushing forward down to the five-yard line. And I tell you what, one of the key players there for Mississippi College was Seth Russo, the backup offensive lineman, wearing number 79.
He got in there and pushed that pile probably a whole yard or two.
So a first down pickup for MC to the five. Choctaw's trying to tie it up. First down, goal to go. White up under center. And it's Creighton, and Creighton down to the one. Did he lean forward? It's very close. He's down just to the one-yard line.
I saw his shoulders come across. I guess they're going to say the knee was down before that.
So second down, goal to go from really the one-foot line here.
And I think they're probably going to just keep feeding Creighton.
Tight formation, almost a victory-like formation. White up under center.
They're going to go QB sneak.
John Henry, does he get the push? He is. No signal yet.
They're signaling him short.
Short. So it'll be third down goal to go from just outside the goal line for MC.
And that's about as close as you can be to the end zone without actually being in it. I mean, it looks like it's the nose is a couple blades of grass away from that end zone line.
White goes over the sideline, gets a new play. They'll break huddle with just eight on the game clock, a play clock rather, and they got to hurry it up here. 3-2-1, and the Choctaws have to call a timeout at the very last minute.
And I believe that's going to leave them with only one timeout.
One this quarter. So timeout, MC. We'll keep it right here. 12:22 to play here in the first half. West Georgia 14, Mississippi College 7. Coming up at halftime, we'll have a conversation with Ron Creighton. And Ron will come up at the half with Charlie. Charlie had that interview coming up at the break, and we'll send it back to the studio where Jay Salmon and the guys will have some first half comments. Look ahead to the second.
Yeah, Creighton, one of my favorite people on this team to talk to, a guy that you can tell really takes it seriously how important his role as the fullback is in this offense, and someone that also you can tell is very hungry to fill that role properly.
Now you'd think he may get a call here.
You almost have to assume so.
They've tried the quarterback sneak. That hasn't worked. So on third down and goal to go from about the one-foot line, the Choctaw's going to try to punch it in again. Creighton is the fullback. Wide up under center. Takes the snap. Going to take it himself off right guard, and he's in. Touchdown, Choctaw.
And I love the play call there as well. The fake handoff to Creighton to clear a hole. And they use him as a lead blocker to give a wide open lane for White to just fall into the end zone.
And they're an extra point away from tying it up. The first quarterback sneak did not get the points. The second did. John Henry running behind the lineman on the right side, Cannon McCulley and Garrett Franklin. Pledger's point after is up is good. 12:19 to play here in the second quarter. We're tied at 14. We'll take a timeout, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor. At CED Tupelo, practicing our company motto of service, integrity, and reliability, CED has everything you need to power your home or business. We also provide materials, for rural broadband connectivity, providing a fast and reliable connection. Our experienced and very knowledgeable staff are always ready to help you find the right products for your project. With our vast selection of inventory and same-day delivery, you can trust us to keep your project running smoothly. CED Tupelo, your one-stop shop for all your electrical needs.
CED's policy of service, integrity, and reliability is the driving force in every community they serve. Visit cedmagnolia.com for more information.
They're tied at 14 with 12:19 to play in the second. Ron Creighton in this game already has 10 carries, 49 yards. Last week against Midwestern State University, a 95-yard touchdown run for the Choctaw junior. It was the second longest touchdown run in Choctaw history, and it was the fifth longest run from scrimmage of any kind in Gulf South Conference history. He didn't get the touchdown on that last drive. John Henry White punched it in. But I think the odds are pretty good that Ron's going to get on the scoreboard here tonight, Charlie.
Yeah, Creighton has really looked good running the ball up the middle in this one, as the Choctaw's option offense has had the elements there. They've been able to get a couple big hitters on the outside, and they've established the run up the middle with Creighton.
Pledger will kick it off from the 35. LaParian Perry back from the two. Straight up the hash marks, upended at the 23.
And another thing to be aware of with the Choctaw offense, Marcus Williams only has one carry thus far. Somebody that we've seen this offense rely on a lot. I wonder if we'll see him get a few more touches as this one goes along and the holes change places with the triple option offense.
Well, you know, he's been asked to do a lot.
Absolutely.
In his last couple of years. But again, I think with the emergence of R.J. Wilson and even Nick Millsaps to an extent, he may not get as many carries because there's a lot to go around. The Wolves back on offense now, and it'll be Cameron Brown coming back out. He's got a passing touchdown and a rushing touchdown already. First and 10 for the Wolves. He's going to take a near side. He's wrapped up in the backfield, and down he goes. Nick Grady was the man who slowed him down, and the Choctaw who finished him off was Keyshawn Brinkley. Loss of 2 yards, second down 12. Good pursuit by the MC defense.
And that goes back to what I was talking about on a previous drive where the Choctaw defense looked like it wasn't moving laterally as quickly as this offense was, but great lateral movement from them there.
Brown under pressure with a flag down. Pass far side is caught by West. He's out of bounds around the 27, but this likely will be coming back because of a holding penalty. You know, the Choctaw defense under Tony Gilbert, the defensive coordinator, hasn't been a real blitzing defense, but this year, even without the blitz, they're getting a lot more pressure up front.
Yeah, and I've seen them add a few small blitz elements on some plays. There was one where they added a linebacker off the right side, but nonetheless, great pressure on these last two plays, really, to put the Wolves behind the sticks.
Penalty is holding against West Georgian. Back to the 11-yard line they go. And from there, it is second down 22 for the Wolves. Cameron Brown takes the snap. Looking left all the way, throws. Pass is caught. Receiver shakes his man out across the 20. Down to the 23. They get the original line of scrimmage, and they'll set up a third and 10 from there. On third downs in this game, West Georgia one out of two. And now they need the 33-yard line to convert. See if the Choctaws can hold them and get the ball right back. Tied at 14, opening minutes of the second quarter. Three wide receivers right, two to the left side, and now West Georgia, I believe, is going to call a timeout. They do. Timeout Wolves, and we'll take one as well. 14-14 is our score, 10:30-7 to play in the second quarter. We'll take a quick break, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
You practice that one thing over and over. After a few thousand reps, you master it. That's why the subspecialists at Mississippi Sports Medicine focus on one specific area of the body. So when they see you, they've seen your condition thousands of times. For a winning outcome, turn to Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Your life, our focus.
West Georgia looking at a 3rd and 10 here after the timeout taken by the Wolves to talk it over. Again, they need the 33-yard line to convert. Too wide to either side with Mosley in at fullback. Brown takes the snap. He's trying to do the hard count here. Still plenty of time on the play clock. There's the snap. He'll drop back. Throwing over the middle. Got a man wide open at the 45. First down pickup for the Wolves.
And that was Steven Peterson out of the slot. The Choctaws pressed both of the outside receivers but sagged off those slots, and that's how he was able to get open on that little shallow post across the middle.
To the 41 and a first down pickup for West Georgia. Wolves move the chains. Quick snap. Brown looking left. Pressure applied. Steps out of the pocket. Down to the 50 and all the way to the Choctaw 47. He goes, picks up 12 yards on the quarterback scramble. The pocket collapsed very quickly, but a good job by Cameron Brown to get out of it. First down for the Wolves at the Choctaw 47. This is going to be a handoff coming near side. Mosley gets a couple of yards, and that's it to the 45. Second down at about 8 coming up. That may have not been Mosley. I think that was Christian Royalston, number 4. I beg your pardon. Second down, 7. Brown to throw. Again, he'll scramble. And again, he's got the first down as he falls over backwards at the 36.
And now it seems like he's kind of found the soft spot as the interior of this Choctaw defensive line. As that's twice now, he's scrambled right up the middle for a nice gain.
Tied at 14 with 8:46 and counting to play in the second. From the 36 of the Choctaws, pass near side is caught, and the Choctaw defender right there to eat him all up. Justin Ephemera is there to make the tackle.
And that time, no hold by the receiver from the Wolves, and they were able to break right through on the screen pass.
Loss of 2 yards, second down, 12 coming up. Line of scrimmage is now the 38. Brown quick toss near side. It's intercepted by the Choctaws. Read perfectly, and guess who? It's old Nick Grady again, his 3rd pick of the season.
And Grady jumped that route beautifully on the curl, just right in front of the receiver as that ball got there. Fantastic interception by Grady.
Two last week against Midwestern State, one for a touchdown. And this one is returned to the 22-yard line of West Georgia Wolves.
And that was the kind of emotional shift I think the Choctaws needed. The Wolves were starting to really wear them down on this offensive drive before that, see if the offense can capitalize.
First and 10 for MC. At the West Georgia 22, it's Creighton skipping over a man at the line. He's down to the 6. First and goal to go. Strong run for Creighton. And now the Choctaws getting ready to take the lead again if they can punch this one home. Creighton is the fullback. John Henry White up under center. And they'll give it to Ron, and he's down to the one.
And I wouldn't be surprised if this just ends up being a Ron Creighton drive if they give it to him one more time here.
Second down, goal to go from the one-yard line for Mississippi College. Same formation, Creighton the set back. It's Ron again, and Creighton is into the end zone. Touchdown, Choctaws.
And you called it. Going into the previous break, Ron Creighton does, in fact, punch one in and get on the scoreboard tonight.
Each team has turned the ball over, and each team has a touchdown off of the turnover. Ben Pledger for the point after try. He remains perfect. 6:51 to play here in the second quarter. 21-14 MC. We'll take a quick break, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests in our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
At halftime of every home game, watch for the Foxes field goal kick from Foxes Pizza Den. One lucky MC student will attempt a 25-yard field goal to win a free large pizza from Fox's Pizza every week of the semester. Fox's Pizza Den of Clinton is a proud sponsor of Choctaw's football. Short drive for MC ends in a Ron Creighton one-yard touchdown run. He's got 71 yards on 13 carries. Wilson and White have also found the end zone, and the Choctaws lead by 7. Kickoff taken by the deep man for the West Georgia Wolves, returning to the near sideline. He's out of bounds at the 26-yard line. Zay Britt on the return. And with 6:42 remaining in the first half, let's see if this Choctaw defense can hold them here. I really do believe this defensive unit has been the key to the Choctaw's success for the most part this season. Now, we have a penalty marker on that run back. It's a holding call against West Georgia.
I think I saw where it was. Javier Batiste was screaming off this near end. Really nice contain from him. But he was brought to the ground right around the 20-yard line, so I think that's what the call is going to be against.
That's the sixth penalty against West Georgia for 60 yards. So they'll start this drive back at their own 17, first and 10. And Cameron Brown is going to hand it off. And a running play between the tackles for Mosley, breaking tackles out across the 40, down to the 42-yard line. He's only 5'7", he's 193. He is tough to bring down.
Just one of those little bowling ball type builds that we see on a lot of running backs, as he was able to just bounce off a few guys' hips for a big gain.
To the 42, a first down pickup for the Wolves. It's Mosley again, this time only a yard or two up the middle. Second and long coming up. We mentioned earlier that John Bland is looking for win number 100. David Dean on the other sideline has 122 career wins. That's the second most of any coach in the Gulf South Conference in history. Bobby Wallace went 152 at North Alabama and West Alabama combined. And right behind David Dean is Choctaw's great John Williams with 121 wins. Quarterback going to throw down the right sideline. Incomplete.
And great coverage once again by Nick Grady to not give that receiver any room coming up the sideline.
Steven Peterson had actually run out of bounds, so he was not going to be able to touch the ball first anyway. Incomplete pass. It's third down nine. So the line to gain for the Wolves to move the chains is the Choctaw 48. Three wide to the left, one to the right side. Choctaws look like they might want to come with some pressure. Send up a linebacker and a safety on third and eight. Here they come. Brown in the pocket, going to throw, pass through the hands of the intended receiver. Incomplete. The Choctaws catch a break because that was going to be a first down.
Yeah,
but
that's West.
West
just
could come up with it. And it's punting time for the Wolves. Riley Mason, a sophomore from Sylvester, Georgia, averaging 42 yards a punt. I think this is the first punt of the game for either team, isn't it?
Yes, sir. That's a high one.
V. Williams, fair catch called for at the 18 as a penalty marker comes in back of the line of scrimmage. And I tell you what, this is guys getting into it, and they have no business getting into it. I don't know who the flag's going to be on. One of the back judges threw the flag about 50 yards up the field towards the line of scrimmage. Way away from the play.
Looks like it was Anderson Watts and Drayvon Hollis for the Choctaws that were involved.
And this is going to go against West Georgia for a personal foul.
And I think a lucky break from MC that it wasn't at least offsetting.
Boy, the Wolves are just killing themselves with penalties here tonight.
Certainly had a few chippy moments in the early going of this one.
My math is right. That is 80 yards in penalties already for West Georgia.
I believe that's correct.
Or is that? No, that, I'm sorry. That penalty was against the Choctaws. It was against the Choctaws. My mistake. I'm watching the referee, and I saw him point one way, and that is going to be against MC. So the Choctaws going to be starting back at their 9-yard line. And this is going to be a quarterback keeper for John Henry White out to the 17-yard line. So that personal foul penalty did get called against Mississippi College.
A crucial tackle there by the Wolves defenders as White had a lot of space in front of him if he'd gotten past those linebackers.
If I remember correctly, at least two, if not three, of the unsportsmanlike penalties last week against the Choctaws at Midwestern State came on punts or kickoffs. Special teams units making those mistakes. Second down, a long two. White looking to throw. Zips it down the seam, and it's incomplete into double coverage.
Student section wants a pass interference against the Wolves on that one, and I kind of have to agree.
It was close. That's Cavante Swanigan, the intended receiver, wearing 14. First time we've called his name this year. Third down two coming up.
That's the first deep shot we've seen the Choctaws take. In fact, their first pass attempt of the entire first half.
You are correct. Third down two. White goes up under center. Line to gain is the 20. And he is going to option it back right side. There's a big first down pickup and more across the 30-yard line to the 32-yard line goes Marcus Williams. We've been talking about Marcus and how he's not getting as many touches perhaps as he has the last couple of years. But He is too talented. You got to keep him involved in the offense.
And if his role can just become that guy that gets the ball, maybe not as much, but he's a big play type of player, and if he can continue to do that like this play, he can certainly continue to impact the offense.
3:55 and counting to play in the second quarter. Choctaws have two timeouts remaining. First and 10 for MC at their own 31. And White's going to fake the handoff. Option keeper for John Henry. He's out to the 37. And so second down at about 4 coming up for Mississippi College. MC up by 7, looking to extend that lead going into the locker room. Creighton to the left of Henry. John Henry White in the backfield. Quarterback's going to keep it. And between the tackles, he goes out to the 43-yard line. And pushing and shoving after the fact again.
No flags thrown, as Creighton was on his back in the middle of that pile.
Following the block of Levi Lott. First down pickup for the Choctaws. Clock rolls, 2:30 to play now in the first half.
Wonder if we see another deep shot soon from this Choctaw offense.
White option keeper spins forward to the 49-yard line. Boy, he got about 5 yards after he was hit there.
Yeah, really good move by White to spin out of that tackle.
And he's at the 49. It'll bring up second down 4. Choctaws need to get to about the 30-yard line to get into field goal range, but they'd like to get to the end zone. And this is Creighton on a handoff, and the Wolves read that one very well.
And I think that's the first time all night that they've really bottled up Creighton.
Amos Don, junior linebacker from Lawrenceville, Georgia, on the stop. Lost back to the 48. Third and 5.
Possibly a passing situation.
Well, the clock rolling now at 1:19 to play in the first half. Again, the Choctaws do have two timeouts remaining. And it's going to be an option keeper for John Henry. Gets back to the opposite 49. It is 4th and 2. And decision time here for John Bland with exactly 1 minute now remaining in the half.
And if I had to predict what they'd do, I think they let this clock run all the way down and then maybe try to go for it in the hopes that they can kick a field goal before half.
They can let it go down to about 25 seconds. Coming up the break, we'll send it back to the studio. Jay Sayman and all the crew will have our halftime show featuring an interview with Choctaw's running back Ron Creighton. That's coming up at the half. So John Bland standing right next to the official calls a timeout with 25 seconds remaining on the game clock. And now it is 4th and 2. Choctaw's football brought to you in part by Trustmark, the bank that fits you to a T. Trustmark, people you trust, advice that works. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. Well, do you punt it here? Or do you go for it on fourth down? I'm obliged to kind of go for it here.
I think I'm with you.
Yeah.
With the success they've had running the ball through this first half, I wouldn't be surprised to see it. But if you look, John Henry White walking back towards the tent, so I think they are going to end up punting this.
Do you see Michael Shine enter the huddle? Sophomore punter from Mobile, averaging 47 yards a kick. We'll try to pin him deep.
And he's got multiple punts over 50 yards, so certainly capable of pinning them deep if he gets the right angle on this punt.
And the key here is the special teams have to not give up a long return and
not
make
a
dumb penalty. Yeah. Zay Britt will go back to receive this kick. He's already talking with the official like, hey, watch for the fair catch signal. And he'll stand back at his own six to take this kick. Shine gets it away. Nice boomer, good hang time. Britt, it's way behind him. It goes into the end zone. Kicked it a little too well, but a nice one nonetheless. And 16 seconds remain in the first half.
Yeah, and while he may not have been able to coffin corner him on this one, tons of hang time on that punt that wasted valuable seconds off the clock.
So West Georgia will have those 16 seconds to try to get down the field in a hurry. Choctaws won this matchup last year 39-38. Deontay Smithmore, the Choctaw quarterback, got hurt, didn't return. John Henry White came on and led them to the comeback win. And now MC looking to go into the locker room with the lead. Running play, Mosley, far side. And he gets down to the 32. The clock will stop in the two-minute range. Does stop after a first down pickup with 9 seconds now to play. And West Georgia is going to call a timeout.
Timeout, West Georgia.
So the Wolves call their second timeout. They'll have one remaining if they can get in position with maybe a long pass play down the sideline, get out of bounds, and have a shot perhaps at a field goal. Brock Pellegrino is their kicker. He is 1-for-2 this season. He has made a 38. He's missed a 46. Touchdown runs in this game for R.J. Wilson and for John Henry White and for Ron Creighton. And for West Georgia, quarterback Cameron Brown has run for one and passed for another. I'm sorry, he's run for two. I beg your pardon. 9 seconds to play. First and 10 from the 32. And they're going to throw deep down the right sideline. And the catch is made with 2 seconds on the clock by Terrell Cole.
And nice job by Cole to go up there and high point the ball. Just beat the Choctaw defender to it.
The line of scrimmage is going to be the 27. So from here, it's a 45-yard attempt for Pellegrino. The Wolves have called their final timeout. So West Georgia able to get the long pass play and get perhaps into field goal range. Pellegrino warming up over there on the sideline. And so he is acting like he's going to be called on to kick it away and try to get him three before they go to the locker room. Again, Pellegrino is made from 38, missed from 46. Very slight breeze tonight coming out of the northwest. The flags not showing much of any movement in the north end zone. So this is going to be Pellegrino. It'll be a 44-yard attempt. Right hash mark. The snap, the hold, the kick is away. It has the distance, and it is good. So West Georgia at the buzzer of the first half gets three. A very entertaining first half of football here tonight in Clinton. Mississippi College will go to the locker room with a 21-17 lead. We'll take a timeout, a two-minute break, and when we come back, we'll go live to the studio where Jay Sayman and the crew has our halftime show for us. Choctaws 21, Wolf 17 at intermission, and MC football will continue in a moment.
Welcome to the Mississippi College Football Halftime Show. I'm Jay Sayman, joined alongside Spencer Winans and Charlie Rook. Your Choctaws lead 21-14 at the half. And guys, let's talk about it. I mean, Spencer, three offensive touchdowns for this Choctaw team in the first half. And through the first two games of this 2023 season, we only saw that amount, three offensive touchdowns in the past two games for the Choctaws. How have they had so much success on the offensive side of the ball?
Yeah, I believe this team's established an identity. Of course, we had a new offensive coordinator come in to introduce the spread offense a little bit, but today it's been all about the triple option. We've generated three touchdowns from three different players off of that, and it's clearly been successful.
Yeah, and on the defensive side, Charlie, we saw a lot of course, passing from West Georgia. We know David Dean likes to do that a lot, but his new quarterback, Cam Brown, he's really relied a lot on his legs so far in this first half. So what have you seen from him in his ability to improvise on a play and pick up the yards?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think Cam Brown's done an excellent job with his legs. He's a really mobile quarterback. He's a really quick quarterback. And we've seen a bit of dual threat action from him tonight. I think the Choctaws are doing an excellent job actually in pass coverage, and we've been able to limit that. But as far as that goes, there needs to be some adjustments made, maybe coming at him with more of a blitz in the second half, trying to shut that down a little bit. But yeah, I think it's going to be an exciting one to see as this game shapes out.
And some scores around the South region. A final, LSU defeats Mississippi State 41-14. Alabama edges out South Florida in Tampa 17-3. Georgia defeats South Carolina 24-14. And finally, Tulane defeats Southern Miss 21-3. A game still in action right now. Ole Miss is up on Georgia Tech 10-0. And we spoke last week with Ron Creighton, had the 95-yard touchdown last week against Midwestern State. But our Charlie Williams spoke with him about the run and the game in action tonight.
I'm here with Ron Creighton, Mississippi College fullback. Ron, thanks for being with us today.
Hey, how are you? Thank you for bringing me.
Last week, Ron, you had 113 yards, including a 95-yard touchdown, the second longest in Choctaw history. Tell me about that run. What did it look like from your perspective?
Man, that run was really great. So Coach Bland called right 15, I think it was. We had seen that the linebackers was like they were flowing so hard the whole game, and John Henry handed it off to me. He was about to pull it and run.
Yeah.
and he handed it off to me, and I broke it, got to about the 50-yard line, and I seen that it was a corner. He was catching up to me, and I looked back, and I seen that he was catching up to me, and I kind of slowed down to get some momentum, and I trucked him, and then I trucked him, and then I was running a little bit more, and I got some good blocks in front of me, and I cut. I got really, really tired, so I decided to dive. It's a really good run.
Yeah, you mentioned the good blocking from that. How's it been running behind this O-line group this year?
They're really good. I mean, they always motivate me. I'm always motivating them. They're so motivating and strong and nasty, and I mean, it's just really good.
Yeah, this year you're filling in, kind of filling some big shoes for Cole Fagan, who had your spot for a couple of years. What's it been like kind of taking that lead role as the fullback in this offense?
Well, first let me talk about how I, like, was behind him, and I learned a lot. He taught me really a lot, and it's like taking this role, it's really tough because I get hit more, I get more carries, and, you know, I'm a leader. Like, people look up to me. I got to be responsible, accountability, all type of crazy stuff.
All right, and, you know, in this offense, it's a big role for the fullback, but it's changing a little bit with Coach Hayes coming in and installing some more spread stuff. Talk to me about what it's been like trying to fill that role in a couple of different offensive sets.
Can you ask me that again?
Yeah. So what's it been like trying to fill the starting role as the offense is changing a little bit?
I mean, this going on my third year, I mean, I never really ran spread, but, I mean, I'm an athlete, so, you know, athletes going to do what they got to do. So, like, to be in that role, like, he has me doing a lot of different stuff. Like, I'm having to, like, run out there and, like, arc block more, perimeter block more. And, you know, it's kind of tough.
Following a couple of long road trips, though, y'all are finally back home. You know, how does that change your approach when you're at home versus on the road? And what are maybe some advantages of being back here?
I mean, I would say the fans, you know, being away is really tough. Being away and trying to win the home game is really tough. So I would say coming back home, especially on family weekend, it's going to be pretty easy knowing that our fans have our back. And I feel like we're going to come out with the win.
All right. And then, you know, speaking of getting back home, we're getting into conference play right now. Tough conference schedule this year. West Georgia coming up first. What are some of the challenges of playing in a tough Gulf South Conference?
Players are bigger, faster, stronger. You just got to be a dog or you're going to get ate.
All right. And speaking of being a dog, if there's one song that Ron Creighton's playing at a workout at in the weight room, whatever, what's that song?
I would say Dreams and Nightmares by Meek Mill.
All right. Thanks for being with us, Ron.
There was a time when a person's word was enough, a time when a handshake meant something, and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways. What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live when they need us most. You deserve more. You deserve a promise.
The if in life, it's a world of possibilities. If you go for a night out with friends, if you can keep an eye on your money along the way, if you know you have overdraft protection with no fee transfers from savings, when you get a low balance alert, it's easier to say yes to fun. If that sounds good, try Regions Life Banking.
Stay ready for the if in life. Regions Bank embrace the if in life.
The right bank, it just fits. With online and mobile tools that give you the freedom to do more. The power to make your dream home yours. And help your business stay on top. Technology that makes one bank fit you to a T.
Don't stop thinking about tomorrow.
Trustmark, people you trust, advice that works.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests and our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best.
Every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
Welcome back to the Mississippi College Football Halftime Show. I'm Jay Samen, once again joined alongside Spencer Winans and Charlie Rook. MC leads once again 21-14 at the half. And let's go ahead and preview that second half action for you. Again, Spencer, three different players have scored, like we mentioned, for this Choctaw offense so far. And how important is it for them to really include everyone in this offense to try and get out this win?
Yeah, absolutely. We talked about the struggling with points early on in the first segment, but now it's important for them to keep the variety, and it keeps West Georgia on their toes, not knowing who's going to get the ball every play.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we talked about the defense, Charlie, of West Georgia, and the coverage so far from the defensive backs and the linebackers has been successful trying to stop the passing game of the Wolves. So what do they need to do in this second half to try and be successful?
Well, they got to keep it up in their coverage. They're doing a really nice job. We saw the Nick Grady pick early in the half, and they're doing a really nice job there. As you just mentioned, linebackers are playing well, safeties are playing well, defensive backs are doing a really nice job. The key is success in the second half. Let's get some pressure on the quarterback. We cannot allow some more scrambles like that. He's got both of the touchdowns so far for West Georgia, and so the defensive line just needs to do a better job just kind of making them uncomfortable in there, and I'm sure we're going to see a similar result.
Yeah, and Spencer, you know, a big thing in that first half was the lack of ball security. We saw a fumble from Marcus Williams that was recovered by West Georgia, and then another one that was thankfully called back from a penalty on West Georgia. So how much do you stress in that locker room to just keep two hands on the ball at all times?
Absolutely. When you're playing ahead, you always want to keep the ball as much as possible. This triple option offense that MC runs keeps them with the ball, and if they keep the ball in their hands, time of possession will go way up for them, keeping the ball away from West Georgia.
Yeah, and we mentioned that fumble that was hold back, you know, called back on the penalty. We saw a lot of West Georgia penalties in that first half, Charlie. So, you know, Mississippi College obviously needs to stay their course, keep their head, and limit those mistakes.
Yeah, absolutely. We saw it in the Midwestern Texas game last week. Mississippi College with about three personal fouls in that entire game. It might have even just been in one quarter. And so just finishing out games and keeping their heads. We saw it getting a little bit chippy in that second half towards the end. And they just need to make sure to keep their cool. They're up in this one. They're doing a really nice job. West Georgia's already given away several penalties, and we've seen it in college football. That changes games. It changes momentum. And Choctaws just need to keep their head, and they're going to find themselves in a good spot.
Some scores around the Gulf South Conference. Shorter defeated Chauwan 57-20. Florida A&M defeats West Florida 17-3. That's a final. Mississippi Valley defeats Delta State 7-6 in a defensive battle. Valdosta State comes back and defeats Kaiser 21-13. And finally, North Greenville defeats West Alabama 20-13. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere because the Mississippi College Halftime Show will return in just a moment.
The right bank. It just fits. With online and mobile tools that give you the freedom to do more. The power to make your dream home yours. And help your business stay on top. Technology that makes one bank fit you to a T. Trustmark. People you trust, advice that...
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests and our community, to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best. Every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor. At CED Tupelo, practicing our company motto of service, integrity, and reliability, CED has everything you need to power your home or business. We also provide materials for rural broadband connectivity, providing a fast and reliable connection. Our experienced and very knowledgeable staff are always ready to help you find the right products for your project. With our vast selection of inventory and same-day delivery, you can trust us to keep your project running smoothly. CED Tupelo, your one-stop shop for all your electrical needs.
CED's policy of service, integrity, and reliability is the driving force in every community they serve. Visit CEDMagnolia.com for more information.
Welcome back to the Mississippi College Football Halftime Show. One final time, your score 21 for Mississippi College, 14 for West Georgia. For a final time, I'm Jay Salmon. Join alongside Spencer Winans and Charlie Rook. Let's send you back to Robinson-Hale Stadium for the start of the second half with Reed Vance and Charlie Williams.
All right, welcome back. Halftime score, Mississippi College 21, West Georgia 17. Bring in Zach Sewell now. And, Zach, you've been watching this ball game up here with us. And what's your takeaway for the first half of football? It's a pretty exciting ball game, huh?
Yeah, if you're a fan of both teams, it was definitely a fun game to watch. And if you're the Choctaws offense, you got to keep feeding Ron Creighton. Ron Creighton is doing a great job of putting the run game on his shoulders. And he doesn't have the most flashy run ability. He just runs behind his pads, gets downhill, and he gets the important runs of 5 yards on first down, which makes second and third down much more manageable. So the more production you can get from him, the better. And in terms of the defense, they looked very well playing complementary football with the offense, using their breaks very well, playing solid defense. However, there were a couple of opportunities to get off the field on third down, and they just kind of slipped up. Third down and 10, third down and 11. They just need to get off the field more often so they can just stay energized for the second half.
I think really one of the keys for Mississippi College, really for both teams in the second half, is whichever team makes the fewest mistakes is going to win this football game. Each team has a couple of turnovers. The Choctaws have gotten a turnover, an interception return from Nick Grady. A couple of fumbles, one for each team as well. West Georgia has had a lot of penalties go against them in the first half. And, you know, I think in a way they're kind of lucky to be down just four.
Absolutely. That's a huge testament to both offenses as well. Both playing very well, and all the credit goes to Cameron Brown for West Georgia. Redshirt freshman quarterback can do it both with his legs, with his arm. West Georgia has done a good job of letting him just kind of get the short throws to warm up his arm and kind of let him loose later in the second quarter. I wouldn't be surprised to see his arm more lively in the second half. But that is a huge testament to both offenses and how well each of them have been playing.
Quick check of other scores around the Gulf South Conference. Florida A&M leading West Florida now 31-10. They're in the fourth quarter. Late third, Delta State leading Mississippi Valley State 22-7. Third quarter, North Greenville 20, West Alabama 13. Fourth quarter, Valdosta 35, Kaiser 19. We're going to take a timeout. And then when we come back, we'll have the start of the third quarter of action here in Clinton. It's the Choctaws 21 and the Wolves 17 at intermission. And we'll take a break, and Choctaws football will continue in a moment. Robinson-Ale Stadium on a beautiful mid-September night. Choctaws 21, Wolves 17. This hometown crowd, Charlie, on family weekend here at Mississippi College. And it is pretty packed on the home side. It's going to be a very nice-sized crowd when it's all said and done. And they have seen an exciting first half of football.
Absolutely. I was downstairs here in the press box during halftime talking to Dr. Thompson about the crowd. Said he loved seeing how many people there are, but said he wants to try to fill some more of these chair backs. And then I also was getting texts from friends where in a couple of group chats there were people saying, hey, this is a great game. The crowd's packed. Y'all get over here. So there's more people on the way.
That's good. The Choctaw is going to need their support in the second half because, you know, the Wolves going to come out and they are going to continue to play well. Again, this game between these two teams went down to the wire last year. 39-38, Choctaw comeback win. They went for two in the end and won it. Wolves will get the football to start the second half. And the kickoff will be taken at the goal line. Run back out, and oh my goodness,
coverage.
What a hit. Holy cow. And for Mississippi College, that's Chase Rush. Backup linebacker, excellent special teamer. And, man, he just leveled the return man.
There was no question about that hit.
Coverage has been really good on special teams all season
long.
The issue has been penalties on special teams. If they could just dial the emotion back a little bit, they have an excellent special team squad this season.
Well, and I think that emotion that you talk about is something that you just have to really gauge with a special teams unit because you've got to get keyed up to get out there and run 40 yards downfield to try to deliver a hit.
Cameron Brown, the quarterback for West Georgia, out to the 24, close to the line to gain for the first down. Remember, Cameron Brown, a redshirt freshman, getting his first start of the year. He replaced Ben Whitlock in the second half of the game last week against Texas A&M Kingsville, a game they lost by three. Brown came in and played the entire second half, and he got the start here tonight. And he is a load to bring down. In fact, now rushing, Cameron Brown has 72 yards on the evening. Got a first down there, first and 10. Handoff this time. This is Mosley across the 30 to the 32.
And you have to assume this Wolves coaching staff is pretty pleased with what they've seen out of Brown so far tonight. You know, they replaced Whitlock because Whitlock was having so much trouble turning the ball over. Four interceptions over those first two games. Brown has not turned it over all night and even run in a couple touchdowns.
8-yard gain there for Mosley, second down two. He really hasn't. Well, he's had several touches. He's got 71 yards. Just kind of seems like a kind of more quiet than usual for him, perhaps. He'll get the call again here. Breaks through the line into the secondary down to the 48-yard line where he's tackled by Grant Watts and not quiet anymore. And that'll put him near about 100 yards.
Choctaw's bringing big Bryson Baker into the game to stuff that middle a little bit. 6 foot, 304 pounds, trying to get somebody in there to clog the middle of this defensive line.
Line of scrimmage becomes the 48 and a first down for West Georgia. Moving left to right here in the third quarter. Man in motion comes near side. Brown takes it, hands it off, bob it to the outside. That's Mosley again across the 40 down to the... Well, you've got him tripped up at the 41, that's what they say, but it's still enough to move the chains for a first down, 11-yard gain. Now, what we saw last week for the Choctaws at Midwestern State, the Mustangs in the second half stuck to the ground and just wore the Choctaws down. Defense couldn't stay off the field. First and 10 for the Wolves here. Mosley again puts his shoulder pads down. Gets about 3 yards after the initial hit. And down to the 34-yard line he goes. Tackle made by Braden Ziegler. Second down three. Two wide left, one to the right side here for the Wolves. Brown's going to keep it, rolls out, and will run with it himself for the first down across the 30, leaps a defender at the end, then gets tripped up out of bounds at the 20. So they're on the 20-yard line of the Choctaws are the West Georgia Wolves with 11:43 to play in the third quarter. Looking to regain the lead. It's 21-14 MC. Line of scrimmage is going to be the 19. This time Mosley will line up in the slot on the right side. As Brown will shut him down, first and 10 at the Choctaw 19-yard line. He's going to run it straight ahead, and he tries to get to the outside, but nothing doing. Good pursuit there by Grand Watts. He got the tackle.
Yeah, that Tiger linebacker spot that Watts and Jamison play where they come off the edge really hard, really great job by Watts to contain on that one.
No gain, second down, 10. Now three wide to the left, one to the right side as Mosley hops back in the backfield. And this is going to be Mosley. And he slips off one man, weaves his way forward down to the 14.
Patient running by Mosley because that one looked like it was shut down from the beginning, but he was able to stay within himself and cut back to gain a couple yards.
And Mosley slow to get up. He is on his knees, bent over with his elbows on the turf.
This could be a really big blow for West Georgia, already missing their leading rusher on the season. If they lose Rajez Mosley, that's another key running back that they're going to be without.
Got 113 yards on the evening.
Already had two touchdowns coming into this game as well.
West Georgia training staff out to attend to Mosley. He is now sitting up, he's still got a knee on the turf. He'll jog over to the sideline. That's a good sign. So Mosley's going to get a breather, well deserved. West Georgia will send on J.B. Carlisle to replace him. In the backfield. Third down five now from the Choctaw 14-yard line. Brown drops back. Now up in the pocket, going to run with it. Has plenty of green, and he scores. Touchdown. 14-yard quarterback scramble. That's been there all night for the West Georgia Wolves.
Yep, that's touchdown number three on the ground for Cameron Brown in his first start here for the West Georgia Wolves.
Just as the pocket collapses, Brown able to scramble forward, and this time a 14-yard score to give the Wolves a lead.
And a long drive by West Georgia, too. They took the opening kickoff of this second half and drained five whole minutes off the clock. The Choctaws just now about to see the ball for the first time in the second half.
Kick is away, and the kick is good. 10:01 to play, third quarter. It is now 24-21 West Georgia. We'll take a break, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
You practice that one thing over and over. After a few thousand reps, you master it. That's why the subspecialists at Mississippi Sports Medicine focus on one specific area of the body. So when they see you, they've seen your condition thousands of times. For a winning outcome, turn to Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Your life, our focus.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests in our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best. every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center is the official orthopedic team of physicians for MC Athletics. Mississippi Sports Medicine provides high quality, personalized treatment for injuries with a rehab and training staff to help you return to peak performance. Call 601-354-4488 to schedule an appointment or visit MississippiSportsMedicine.com to schedule one online. 10:01 to play in the third quarter. West Georgia 24, Mississippi College 21. Last drive for West Georgia, 9 plays, 86 yards, capped by a 14-yard touchdown run by Cameron Brown, his third touchdown run of the night. Kickoff goes out of bounds.
So another mistake by the special teams unit for West Georgia, giving MC good field position.
If you missed the news, West Georgia is on their way out of the Gulf South Conference. They have announced they're going to be moving to Division I. Longtime member of the GSC. They have had facilities to make that move for quite a while. They've got an excellent staff. And now I guess they found everything else they needed to make that move. Talk more about that as the game goes along here in the second half. First and 10 for MC. Running play straight ahead out to the 38-yard line. Second and 7 coming up. I got attacked by a cricket here in the press box.
And now he's just hanging out on your game
notes. He just is.
Big football fan, I guess.
Kept my cool. But this fella, there he goes. Go bother somebody else.
he was very interested in your game notes.
He was. All right, 3-yard gain on that last run. Second down, 7 coming up. Choctaw's the ball on the far hash, moving right to left. Quarterback keeper, John Henry White, tripped up at the 40-yard line. This will be the final year of the Gulf South Conference for West Georgia. For perspective, North Alabama made the move 5 years ago in football. They are 15-32 since. 7 of those wins came in their first season when they were still playing a lot of Division II teams. West Georgia's got a great chance to succeed at Division I, the FCS level, but it's going to take a little time. And a fumble, bad exchange. And fortunately, John Henry White falls on it back at the 39. It's fourth down.
And this is something we really don't want to see for this Choctaw offense that I feel like we see all too often, where as we get into the second half, and especially the fourth quarter, the offense kind of goes stale as the defense settles in a little bit with the triple option. So it'll be interesting to look to see if the offense maybe brings out some new wrinkles throughout this second half.
A rare 3-and-out of this ball game for either team. Michael Schein on to punt.
Second punt of the game for the Choctaws.
Got it away under pretty good pressure. A boomer, look at this, all the way back to the 10-yard line. And the coverage excellent once again. Return man out to the 16. So anyway, and Jace Amon, our producer back in the studio, you can throw up that list of Gulf South Conference teams over the next 3 years. You see the lineup this year, and then you see the lineup next year. We'll recommend Erskine next year, Chawan and North Greenville also a part of that. But then in 2025, right now just 5 teams will be playing football in the Gulf South Conference. Delta, MC, Valdosta, West Alabama, and West Florida. That's it.
And I wouldn't be surprised to see West Florida make a move similar to what we're seeing out of West Georgia right now.
It is one of those things we've heard for years.
Great
pursuit by Grant Watts as he tracks down the running back of the 10-yard line. That'll be a loss of some 7 yards.
And that's the second time this third quarter we've seen the Tiger linebacker make some have some great speed off the edge to get into the backfield and disrupt a play.
Second and 15 coming up. Just to finish up the thought on the GSC, in 2025, 5 teams will be playing football. There's got to be a plan, you would hope, to add more. There has to be.
And correct me if I'm wrong, you need 6 to get an automatic bid to the playoffs.
Second and 15, throw far side, complete, out of bounds, the 22-yard line. The key there is there's a 2-year grace period that allows you to kind of get away with fewer than 6.
Conference also recently added Trevecca Nazarene.
That's right.
But doesn't support football.
They don't play football. But that's going to be a great road trip for us up in Nashville.
Absolutely.
Welcoming in Trevecca. They'll be members starting next year.
And a good basketball program up there,
yes,
from what I know.
Third down 5 for the Wolves as the Choctaws look to hold them to a 3-and-out. Brown takes the snap, dropping back. Steps out of the pocket, being chased to the near side, and they get to him. Back at the 20-yard line. Hot pursuit by the Choctaw defense.
And once again, great speed shown off the edges by these Choctaw linebackers.
It is going to be fourth down after a loss of a yard.
And that time it was Marquez Grace, the big defensive lineman, finishing that play off.
It's old Roscoe P. Coltrane special, hot pursuit. Good field position coming up here, you'd think, for MC. Return man stands back of the 40.
Nearly blocked. That punt was bothered.
It'll bounce out of bounds. Referee will come in and spot it at the 47-yard line, just shy of midfield. 6:05 to play in the third quarter. 24-21 West Georgia. And now the Choctaws are going to get the football back.
And like I mentioned a minute ago, something we see a little too often with this offense is it starts to go stagnant in the second half. I wonder, as they come out in the shotgun on this one, I wonder if we're going to see maybe some different wrinkles than what we've seen so far in this one.
John Henry White in at quarterback for Mississippi College. Creighton behind him in the backfield. Quarterback option, near side. And the option goes to Williams along the near sideline, and he's all the way down to the 21.
And somebody whose name we've called a lot in this one, R.J. Wilson, with a massive block to open up the seam for Williams, getting congratulated by his quarterback as they come up the field.
So important is correct. If you are going to play running back or wide receiver in this game, you had better know how to block, or you'll be on the sidelines a lot. Down to the 21, first and 10 for the Choctaws. And a whistle. And West Georgia's going to call a timeout. The Choctaws have them on their heels a bit. We'll take a break, 5:30 to play in the third quarter. 24-21 West Georgia. And MC football will continue in a moment.
There was a time when a person's word was enough. A time when a handshake meant something and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways. What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live when they need us most. You deserve more. You deserve a promise.
The if in life, it's a world of possibilities. If you go for a night out with friends, if you can keep an eye on your money along the way, if you know you have overdraft protection with no fee transfers from savings, when you get a low balance alert, it's easier to say yes to fun. If that sounds good, try Regions Life Banking.
Stay ready for the if in life. Regions Bank embrace the if in life.
All right, 5 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the third quarter. West Georgia 24, Mississippi College 21. And it's first and 10 for the Choctaws at the 21-yard line of the Wolves.
And that's an offsides.
You better
Once
believe
again,
it.
Once again, R.J. Wilson going in motion. That's the second time this game. Wilson's been able to draw them offsides just by going in motion on a kind of routine move for this offense.
Both the defensive end came across and one of the safeties. Live stats has him 6 penalties, 60 yards. That's not right.
I think it's closer to 80 at this point.
5 yards here makes it 1st and 5. Down to the 16-yard line, 1st and 5. This is Creighton between the tackles. Inside the 15, down to the 14-yard line. So 2nd down 3 coming up for Mississippi College. MC now at 200 yards rushing, averaging 242, best in the conference. And Creighton has 74. And this is going to be an option keeper for the quarterback, and John Henry strung out along the near side of the formation, only back to the 16. He lost a couple of yards. Good job there by the Wolves defender.
Wonder if they'll go to the shotgun like they have these last couple third downs.
Third down 5 coming up.
Something also worth noting, if they don't convert here, this is well within range of Ben Pledger.
He's already hit a 46-yarder this season. On 3rd down 5. And this is Creighton barreling straight ahead.
We're not
he
gonna
is
have to
inside
worry about the
10.
Kick.
Ben can stay on the sideline. First down goal to go for MC. You know, you talked to Ron for our halftime interview this week, and he talked about how much he learned from Cole Fagan.
Absolutely.
Last year. Fullback did a good job with the Choctaws last couple of seasons, and now it's Creighton really is the featured back. For MC, he's become that guy.
Something else that really struck me in that interview with Ron is just how confident he is in himself and this team.
He gets pushed back here by Amos Don, the linebacker.
Come on, let's not have a penalty. A little extracurricular activity involving Marcus Williams after that play, as a West Georgia player had a handful of his face mask.
Creighton's going to get a breather. He'll come to the sideline. And Nick Millsap will go in to replace him at running back. 2nd down goal to go now from the 10-yard line for MC. So Millsap deep in the pistol. Quarterback keeper. Nice hole near side. He dives. He scores. Touchdown, John Henry White. Boy, the hole really opened up for him. Got to credit that offensive line for providing the seal there and allowing the quarterback to get in the end zone.
Yeah, they did their job as the run up the middle wasn't there, so they sealed off to the left, and White had plenty of room to dive in for that one.
Pledger's point after is good. 2:55 to play here in the third quarter. It's Mississippi College 28, West Georgia 24. We'll take a quick break, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor. At CED Tupelo, practicing our company motto of service, integrity, and reliability, CED has everything you need to power your home or business. We also provide materials for rural broadband connectivity, providing a fast and reliable connection. Our experienced and very knowledgeable staff are always ready to help you find the right products for your project. With our vast selection of inventory and same-day delivery, you can trust us to keep your project running smoothly. CED Tupelo. Your one-stop shop for all your electrical needs.
CED's policy of service, integrity, and reliability is the driving force in every community they serve. Visit cedmagnolia.com for more information.
Wolves on the return from a yard deep in the end zone out to the 21-yard line. Britt on the kickoff return for West Georgia. Choctaws by four with 2:49 to play in the third. Each team 1-1 entering this ball game. West Georgia last year 8-2 to finish 5-2 in the conference. They finished third, and inexplicably in my mind, they did not make the Division II postseason. Their only two losses last year, as they look at a 1st-and-10.
And a different quarterback in the game now.
Yeah, this is going to be Ben Whitlock back in the ball game. And a running play to the far side nets them about 3 or 4. Last year, West Georgia lost by 1 at home to MC. They lost by 14 on the road to West Florida, who wound up tied for the conference championship with Delta State. The Wolves won 5 straight to end the year by an average of 47 a game. They finished 8-2, and they didn't make the playoffs. How does that happen?
I couldn't tell you. They were one of the most dominant teams
that we saw.
One of the most dominant teams in the South, for sure.
Whitlock looking to throw. Pass is incomplete and nearly picked off. David Brown had a beat on that one. Whitlock's problems, 3 interceptions last week. That's what got him benched for the start of this game. But he's out here to start this drive. And he's looking at very quickly at a 3rd-and-6. It's a sophomore from Johns Creek, Georgia. He's completed just over 50% of his passes. 3rd-and-6, lined against the 32. Whitlock drops back, throws near side, passes incomplete, and again it is Brown there to break it up.
And you can see on that play why Whitlock struggles with interceptions so much. He telegraphed that
throw.
He
really did.
I think everybody in the stadium knew exactly where that ball was going, and David Brown was able to read it and break that one up.
In fact, if Brown cuts to the inside of the receiver instead of the outside, he's picking that one off and
scoring.
Exactly.
It was going to look just like Nick Millsap's interception from earlier. Nick Grady.
Grady, yeah. 4th down in the punting unit on for West Georgia. Riley Mason. It's away. Good hang time. Not a long kick. Take it to the 35. And it's going to be returned for only a couple of yards by V. Williams. Choctaws will have it with 1:52 to play in the third. 28-24, Mississippi College, our score.
Yeah, and this West Georgia special teams unit able to get down the field really quickly on the back of these punts because they're getting crazy hang time. I mean, we're losing the ball in the lights as it goes up just about every time.
Choctaws have started their own 37, leading by 4. It'd be nice to have a 2-score lead. Let's see if MC can make it happen. White takes the snap, runs with it. Nice hole, through the line, past the 50, down to the 44. Deontay Overstreet, the only man to stop him and prevent him from scoring. First down, MC.
Nice job by White to make a quick decision and pull the ball, cut up field.
They'll spot him down at the 45 officially. First down and 10 for the Choctaws inside West Georgia territory. Wideouts left and right for MC. White goes up under center. He'll keep it again. Same play. This time he gets about 7 yards. We talked about it a lot, but John Henry, 5'11". 190, but man, he can take a beating, can he?
Absolutely. I mean, for not a very big guy at all, but he takes hits and just keeps jumping right up. Almost seems like he invites contact a lot. We can see him leaning in to the defense to try to get every extra yard that he can.
John Henry over 70 yards rushing at the moment, 75 to be precise. 2nd down 3 from the 38. And this is Creighton between the tackles to the 35, maybe the 34. That's going to move the chains.
And something that I've talked about a little bit throughout this one is how in this triple option offense, as the game progresses, you see different players start to gain chunk plays consistently. And it looks like throughout this third quarter, the guy that's really emerged has been John Henry White after Creighton was kind of the dominant offensive player in the first half.
That's going to be the end of the third quarter. After three, it's Mississippi College 28, West Georgia 24. We'll take a timeout. The fourth quarter is next, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment. Reed Vance, Charlie Williams, Zach Sewell with you from Robinson-Hale Stadium in Clinton. Family weekend here at MC, and the big crowd seeing a great game. 28-24 MC as we start the fourth quarter. The Choctaws have it first and 10 at the West Georgia 33. And this is Ron Creighton, steady performer tonight, out to the 30-yard line. That'll give him 89 yards on the evening.
He's averaging about 4.5 yards per carry so far in this game, and that's been just about what the doctor ordered out of this fullback spot, as he's just able to consistently put the Choctaws in a good situation on second down.
Second down 7 here. Wideouts left and right. White takes the snap, and he is going to keep it after faking the handoff, and he weaves his way out to the 25. Nice strong run of about 6 yards, setting up a third down 1.
And he's done this a few times where he fakes the handoff to Creighton, and then Creighton really serves as a lead blocker, and he'll follow him right up between the tackles for a nice gain.
So third down 1 coming up here for MC as the Choctaws look to extend their 4-point lead just outside the red zone right now.
What do you think on third and 1? Do we get a QB sneak, or do you think Creighton gets the ball?
Well, White's up under center, and it is going to be a quarterback sneak. And he gets to the 23, and that should be just enough for the first down. No signal yet on whether to move the chains from the officials.
It's close.
Very close. And now they say move them. First down. And the new line of scrimmage is the 23. On first and 10, this is Creighton, and he is stuck and stuck hard in the backfield. That is number 42 for West Georgia, Jalen Tarver, linebacker. Yeah, nice job by Tarver.
Tarver timed that snap perfectly. He was right about at the line of scrimmage when that one was snapped.
2 yard loss for MC's second and 12. Play call coming in from the Choctaw sideline. First-year offensive coordinator Cortland Hayes, along with John Bland, calling the plays. Second down, 12. Pitch near side. Williams needs a block. Got one from Wilson. He's down to the 20-yard line.
Nice job to make something out of nothing there by Marcus Williams as they had sealed the corner pretty well, but he was able to cut back and gain about five.
So now you're looking at third and seven.
Wonder if we finally see the Choctaws go to the air for just the second time in this game.
Yeah, John Henry's 0 for 1. That's it.
And we talked pregame about we wondered which identity they would lean into. They answered that question pretty emphatically throughout this one.
Third and seven. John Henry pitches at the last minute to Williams, who's knocked out of bounds to the 42.
That's got to be a late hit. Thank you. As two or three West Georgia players hit him on the sideline.
Three penalty flags flying. And that's going to give MC a first down because they were nowhere near the line to gain for the first down.
He wasn't just out of bounds. He was past the blue strip that marks where we are, where we're out of bounds. It was late and then some.
We may have to check for a hole in the wall in the booth next door to us, the West Georgia coaches. I don't know if you people at home heard that, but somebody put a big fist somewhere. I can understand their frustration.
It's a bad mistake.
What it does is it gives a clock-eating team a fresh set of downs in the red zone.
Chance to eat more clock and a chance to push it to a two-score game. A very, very costly penalty.
Again, the live stats have him now with eight penalties for
96 yards, is that what I'm seeing?
Is that what you see? I see something else, but mine may not be caught up just yet, but that sounds about right. I see 65 yards, but it's at least 85 by now. First and 10 for the Choctaws. Line of scrimmage is now just outside the 10.
Almost another offsides.
Linebacker was coming with the blitz, but was able to stop himself. Play clock down to 3. 1. And John Bland, seeing that, calls his first timeout of the half. Timeout on the field. Choctaws lead it 28-24. We'll take a quick break, and MC football will continue in a moment.
You practice that one thing over and over. After a few thousand reps, you master it. That's why the subspecialists at Mississippi Sports Medicine focus on one specific area of the body. So when they see you, they've seen your condition thousands of times. For a winning outcome, turn to Mississippi Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Center. Your life, our focus.
Choctaw fans have a new way to follow their favorite MC teams online. Blue and Gold is the student media group at Mississippi College covering campus news, sports, arts, and more. Reading is always free. Subscribers receive the latest stories directly in their email inbox. Visit blueandgoldmc.com. This will be a fun one to write up about, won't it, Charlie?
Absolutely. I'm looking forward to writing this recap tonight. Looking forward to getting to talk to Coach Bland after this one as well.
Yes. Our Blue and Gold sports crew doing a great job with our production tonight. After the Choctaw timeout, first and 10, just outside the 10-yard line, closer to the 11 for MC. Creighton's in at fullback. White goes up under center. He'll take it himself. Pitch back to Williams, right side. Marcus tackled by the ankles along the near sideline at about the 7-yard line by Cale Bright, the defensive back for West Georgia. Second down, 6. Second Line of scrimmage now the seven for MC. And this time we got movement, I think, on the MC offensive line.
I think the whole offensive line just about moved before the snap.
So I think somebody on that left side went first, but there was clear movement, and that'll set the Choctaws back from second and six to second and 11. So the line of scrimmage becomes the 12. Second down from there. Quarterback, keeper.
That's
touchdown.
Creighton.
Creighton, I beg your pardon. He faked me out. And one, Creighton scores it for MC.
They faked you out and faked everybody else out, too. I think Creighton was just about untouched. And a 10-point lead for the Choctaws.
Ron Creighton on the touchdown run. His second of the night. One after is good by Ben Pledger. 10-13 to play in the ballgame. And the Choctaws now lead it. 34-24 over West Georgia. We'll take a break. And Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests in our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best. Every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
The right bank. It just fits. With online and mobile tools that give you the freedom to do more. The power to make your dream home yours. And help your business stay on top. Technology that makes one bank fit you to a T. Trustmark. People you trust. Advice that works.
It is 35-24. Mississippi College with the lead. Now with 10-13 to play in the ballgame. West Georgia needs a big return. Zay Britt gives him one past the 30 to the 32. So now West Georgia down by two scores. And you think they would have to have a little more urgency. Ben Whitlock came in for their last drive. Cameron Brown was the man up until that point. We'll see who they bring out at quarterback now.
And I really don't understand the decision to bring Whitlock into the game at that
Unless
point.
Brown is hurt, and we don't know it. But I see Brown on the sideline.
There's Whitlock again.
I'm looking over to the West Georgia sideline.
You have to assume Brown is hurt because he was playing fantastic.
If that is him, he doesn't have a helmet, so perhaps he is shaken up. First and 10 for West Georgia at the 32. Hand off, and this is Mosley. Tackled from behind at the 37-yard line. About a 5-yard gain, second down five.
And again from Mosley, just a nice, patient, steady run. We've seen him have a few of those where he doesn't really hit the hole hard. He just takes his time and picks around to get a few yards.
Now from the 37, a second down five. Whitlock takes the snap. Three-step drop, looking to throw. Fires over the middle. Incomplete. Too high over everybody's head. Intended for Javen West.
Nick Grady was about 2 inches away from having another interception. As Whitlock, again, forced that one into double coverage with a third Choctaw defender not far away.
Third down. This is a huge third down here for West Georgia. They're down 11 with 9:25 to play in the game. They need the 42-yard line to convert. Three receivers right, one to the left side. No pressure. Whitlock steps back, throws near side to no one in particular. Incomplete. Somebody ran an incorrect route.
I think he was assuming that he was going to see a corner route out of Cole on the near side, but instead he just went straight upfield.
West Georgia is going to keep their offense on the field. David Dean says, hey, it's getting too late. We can't allow these Choctaws to get the ball back and take a lot of time off the clock, so they're going to go for it on fourth and five.
And correction, that was Tubbs, not Cole.
This could be the ball game. Listen to the crowd. Fourth and five, quarterback to throw, right side. It is caught, and that's just enough for the first down at the 43.
That's close. That was
very
close.
Terrell Cole made the catch in heavy traffic.
And Brown nearly knocked that one away again.
Now hurry up to the line. First and 10 now at the 43. Again, Whitlock to throw, right sideline, and the receiver drops it. He had it in his hands, couldn't come down with it. Incomplete.
Big break for the Choctaws.
That was Steven Peterson.
Yep, and Jacoby Graves delivered the hit to knock that one away. But a lucky break for the Choctaws, as I think there was a mistake in coverage, as it looked like a cover two on the far side, and the cornerback just didn't play that deep enough.
So second and 10 now for West Georgia. Whitlock going to throw. Pump fake. Now lets it loose over the middle. Pass is caught on a crossing pattern by Terrell Cole, and he'll waltz into the end zone.
And Nick Grady is down as he looked like he got hit by one of his own teammates coming across to try to make a play on the ball. As I think he might have even taken a hit on the head.
Yeah, two Choctaws kind of collided there. Cole was able to make the catch. And Nick's standing up. That's a good sign. And the Wolves are not going to go gently. That makes it a five-point ball game. And now kind of have to, we don't have to, but you got to consider at least going for two, right?
It would make sense, make it a three-point ball game. Give your kicker a chance to tie this up late.
That's what they're going to do is, nope, they're going to send the kicking unit out. Pellegrino on to try to kick the point after. I don't know if this is one of those times where you look at the play sheet and it tells you what to do, go for it or kick it. But they're going to kick it, trying to make it a four-point ball game. Pellegrino for the PAT. And the kick is away, and it is good. 8:38 to play here in the fourth quarter. Mississippi College 35, West Georgia 31. We'll take a quick break, and Choctaws football will continue in a moment.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor. At CED Tupelo, practicing our company motto of service, integrity, and reliability, CED has everything you need to power your home or business. We also provide materials for rural broadband connectivity, providing a fast and reliable connection. Our experienced and very knowledgeable staff are always ready to help you find the right products for your project. With our vast selection of inventory and same-day delivery, you can trust us to keep your project running smoothly. CED Tupelo, your one-stop shop for all your electrical needs.
CED's policy of service, integrity, and reliability is the driving force in every community they serve. Visit CEDMagnolia.com for more information.
Four-point Choctaw lead, 8:38 to play in the game. Kickoff goes to Marcus Williams from the four. Up the numbers. Nice hold to the 30. Penalty marker comes down. He's out to the 39, so this is probably coming back a little bit.
And some extracurriculars after the hit.
Don't see a penalty marker on that. I just see A penalty marker back at the 30-yard line.
And Nick Grady is up and walking around on the Choctaw sideline. Looks like he'll be okay.
Yeah, he's got his helmet in his hand, too. That's always a good sign. When they don't have the helmet in the hand, that's the sign that they're not coming back. Holding against the Choctaws.
We saw him get a couple words of encouragement from Mrs. Bland as well.
Candace, always the Choctaws' biggest cheerleader down there. And the whole family is invested, the Bland family, so invested in this program.
Every game, all the Blands on the sideline.
Penalty was committed at the 30, 10 yards from there, makes the 20. That's where the Choctaws will start, first and 10. With 8.5 minutes to play in the ball game, they're leading by 4. Wide up under center.
Once again, very close to an offsides by West Georgia.
Ron Creighton down to the 23. You don't want to be too conservative here, but this is the kind of situation the Choctaws are kind of built for in order to hang on to a lead and win a ball game, right? I mean,
you have to assume
all control offense,
yeah.
Keep it on the ground, keep that clock running, get points at the end.
And with the new clock rules especially, it really plays
yes.
into the Choctaws' hand.
Quarterback keeper down to the 27 goes John Henry White on the near side. Yeah, the new rules are the clock continues to roll after every first down, except in the last 2 minutes of each half. Third down three for MC, line to gain is the 30. See if the Choctaws can move the chains. Keep the offense on the field with a 4-point lead halfway through the fourth quarter. And Creighton is stacked up along the left side of the line. They don't get anywhere close. Only back to the line of scrimmage, and it's fourth down. Here comes the kicking unit.
And that one could end up costing us.
The defense is going to have to win this game for Mississippi College, it appears.
And on the previous drive, the defense looked good until the big mistake with the defenders colliding that allowed the touchdown. And you just have to hope that they're able to lock in a little bit better and keep Whitlock from driving them down the field.
Zay Britt to return the kick. Short kick. Good Choctaw bounce, and Britt picks it up at the 33, returns it to the 40.
Risky play
Very
by Britt to try
indeed.
To pick that one up.
So West Georgia will begin there, first and 10. Next week, the Choctaws go on the road to take on the West Alabama Tigers. 6 o'clock kickoff from Livingston. Pregame will begin at 5:45. Next home game doesn't come until October 14th when Valdosta State comes to town.
Nick Grady on the field for the Choctaw defense, and that's big. He's one of the better players in this defensive backfield.
So first and 10 here for the West Georgia Wolves. They'll start from their own 41. Whitlock at quarterback takes the snap, hands it off to Mosley. And Mosley to the right side gets out to the 48. Seven-yard pickup, second down seven coming up. Clock rolls, we're at 6 minutes to play in the game. The decision to go for one and not two may wind up costing West Georgia. They need a touchdown to take the lead. Whitlock hands it off. Mosley comes near side, tackled at the 48-yard line by Zach Hammond. That's enough, though, for a first down to the 49 of MC.
That's a favorable spot as Hammond tackled it right near the line to gain.
And we've got it Choctaw down on the field in the secondary. Looks to be cramps in the legs of David Brown, the safety. Fourth-year man out of Shreveport. Came into this game as the leading tackler on the team. Choctaw trainer Matt Verrett over to help him up, and Brown will come over to the sideline. He'll have to sit out at least to play. Clock will roll again, 5:25 and counting now to play in the fourth quarter. Choctaw's by four. And a handoff, and not much there for Mosley. It was Deshaun Washington who slowed him down.
Able to break a couple of tackles, though.
Gets 3 yards, second down seven. 5 minutes to play in the game. Line of scrimmage, the 46. Hand off again, Mosley near side. Across the 40 and down to the 36. And that's enough for a West Georgia first down.
And we talked about clock control earlier, but if West Georgia is able to drain a lot of this clock and get points on the board, it could create a very difficult situation for the Choctaw offense.
Big night for Mosley. As he is now at near 150 yards rushing.
Also, Zach Hammond, worth noting, came off the field holding one arm very straight. Possible injury there.
Mosley again, nice hole on the right side. They'll slow him down but not tackle him until he gets to the 12-yard line. And you can see there are some Choctaws a little tired back in the secondary. As here, Jacoby Graves is slow to get up, cornerback. And now he gets up, and he and one of the Wolves players jawing a little bit. Referees come in to break him up.
Still no flags. As almost the entire West Georgia bench cleared to come in. Exchange some words there.
Well, good job by the officials to get everybody in the middle of that. Let's see, is there a penalty marker down on this play?
I didn't see one.
Clock has stopped, 3:45 to play in the fourth quarter. The Wolves are all huddled up along the far sideline like...
As if it's a timeout or something, timeout, but the officials are barking at them to clear the field.
So here they come up to the 12-yard line as West Georgia looks to take the lead in the closing minutes of the fourth quarter. Mosley, the running back. Whitlock sends a man in motion. And Mosley on the run is decked.
That's
at
Grant
the 11-yard
Watts.
Line. Grant Watts indeed.
Saw a helmet fly out of the pile after that.
Yeah, Wolves player lost his hat.
Again, no flag.
Marvin James, the left guard, has to sit out of play, lost his helmet. Second down nine coming up. As we approach 3 minutes to play in the game. 35-31 Choctaws. Choctaws showing a little blitz here. Whitlock to throw over the middle, passes.
Did he get it?
Caught. Or at least
Choctaw defender.
It may have been caught by a receiver and a Choctaw. Let's see. Referees haven't signaled yet.
This may be worth a review.
Yeah, we are going to have, I would think, if this is a reception,
Trajan Anderson,
it's a
Watts.
Touchdown.
Trajan Anderson Watts has the ball, but they're signaling it's a touchdown.
They're signaling it's a touchdown. John Bland is going to send this one to the replay tent, which is back beyond the south end zone. We're going to get our first
are they
replay
allowed to
of the
touchdowns?
Season. Well, of course they are. You would certainly think so. John has got that red flag in hand. He's going to let the official make the announcement, and he drops it on the turf.
I think a smart use of the challenge, because that ball was, I mean, the dictionary definition of a 50-50 ball, as there were two Choctaws and a Wolf all with their hands on it as it got into the end zone.
Terrell Cole, I think, was the receiver who caught the ball, and it is going to be a coach's challenge. John challenged one last week, didn't win it. This will be the first one here at home. And again, it's a new system in Division II in the Gulf South Conference. Coaches have a challenge that they can use in each half. The referee will go over to the tent that has been set up beyond the south end zone here at Mississippi College at Robinson-Ale Stadium. And they are able to go back and look at each play individually. They should get a pretty good look based on the angle of the pass to the receiver. But I'm just going to tell you, this is going to be tough to overturn.
It will be, but depending on their angle. I mean, Trajan Anderson Watts seemed very convinced that he had that ball.
For the moment, West Georgia has a two-point lead with 2:55 to play. And time enough for the Choctaws to move the ball down the field and at least get in field goal range. I don't know, for the record, if you're watching at home, that our production crew has given you a replay of this or not, but I can tell you that what the officials are looking at is not what you're seeing at home. It's two totally different feeds. All right, here comes the referee out of the tent. He'll go and talk with his officials. No, he's not. He's just going to come out and give us the indication. Whatever, he can't get his mic to work. Don't know what the call is going to be. It's going to be touchdown Wolves. Yeah, I just don't know that the angles was going to be there to overturn it. So the Wolves have a 37-35 lead with 2:55 remaining. Big point after try here for Pellegrino. That call and that touchdown took a lot of the wind out of the sails of the fans on the home sideline. But now Pellegrino will try to make it a three-point ball game. A snap, the hold, the kick is away, and the kick is good. So at 2:55 to play in the ball game, West Georgia has a three-point lead, 38-35. We'll take a quick break, and Choctaw's football will continue in a moment.
There was a time when a person's word was enough, a time when a handshake meant something, and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways.
What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live when they need us most. You deserve more. You deserve a promise.
The if in life, it's a world of possibilities. If you go for a night out with friends, if you can keep an eye on your money along the way, if you know you have overdraft protection with no fee transfers from savings, when you get a low balance alert, it's easier to say yes to fun. If that sounds good, try Regions Life Banking.
Stay ready for the if in life. Regions Bank embrace the if in life.
All right, the Choctaws would like a nice kickoff return here. Let's see if they get one to return. It is going to be Marcus Williams from the 1 yard line coming to the near numbers. Got a seam to the 30. Pushes a man down to the 32. Not bad at all. 2:47 now remaining in the game. West Georgia 38, Mississippi College 35. And the Choctaws need to get into field goal range to try a game tying kick. Preferably need to get in the end zone to go home with a win. Ben Pledger's long this year, 46. So you think they got to get really to about the 30-yard line to get in his range. First and 10 for MC. And this is going to be a quarterback keeper on the option. And White tackled at the 30-yard line after a gain of about four.
Looks like they'll give him the 31.
Michael Merriweather on the stop. Choctaws have only one timeout remaining.
But like you mentioned, with the new clock rules, inside of 2 minutes, they're going to stop the clock after each first down. Something the Choctaws are going to need to rely on.
White drops back, going to pass on the run, incomplete. He was hit as he threw and knocked to the ground.
He's slow to get up.
Jalen Tarver, the man who hit him to the ground.
And he's holding
that left
his
knee.
Left knee that's already got a brace on it. That's the ACL that he tore during camp in his true freshman season.
Incomplete pass, third down, six. Clock stops, 2:14 to play in the game. Option, back, Williams, near sideline to the 37, and that's going to be enough for the first down. He got to the 38. Late pitch, but he got it.
And John Henry's
still hurt. He can't get up now.
He got hit late on that one as well.
Clock will stop with 2:02 to play.
And that's not what you want to see before this drive.
So we're going to see Cam Davis come in the ball game for the first time tonight. Sophomore transfer from Southwest. He'll have to come on for at least one play as John Henry is going to get helped up off the turf by trainer Matt Verrett. He'll walk off to the sideline and keep his helmet on and stand right there, ready to go if needed.
I think he's going to want to come in as soon as possible, but I don't know if they're going to let him.
Yeah, Matt's going to stay right there next to him. Matt Verrett, our athletic trainer, is the absolute best. And he's going to make sure those guys, when they get ready to go in the game, that they are actually ready to go in the game.
That was two straight plays that John Henry took huge hits right after getting rid of the ball.
So Cam Davis comes in at quarterback, and he can throw. First and 10 from their own 38-yard line. We're now under 2 minutes to play in the game. Davis fires right sideline, and too long intended for V. Williams. Second and 10 coming up. Clock stops, 1:52 to play. 38-35 West Georgia. Williams in the backfield along with Davis. Davis over the middle. Pass is caught and down to the 48-yard line.
And that's a first down that'll stop the clock.
It is a first down pickup. Catch made by Orion Thompson, who was targeted a couple of times last week by Davis. A minute 44 to play. From the 49. Pressure coming, left side at the numbers, and the catch is not made. Thompson dropped it.
That was a perfect throw from Davis.
Dropped it at the 45. Second and 10, clock stops, a minute 34 to play. Again, the Choctaws need to get to the 30-yard line to realistically be in comfortable range for Ben Pledger, but may have a little more distance than that on special occasions like this. Second and 10, quick toss, right side, pass caught at the 47, and he stayed in bounds. Batiste made the catch. Clock rolls a minute 21 to play. Third and 6. Two receivers to either side. Davis takes the snap. Third and 6 over the middle. Pass dropped at the 41. That would have been a first down. And this next play on fourth down could be it. Choctaws came back late, beat West Georgia in Carrollton last year. Now the Wolves trying to do the same to the Choctaws here in Clinton in 2023. And West Georgia has two timeouts. They're going to take one here.
And that's two really costly drops.
Yes.
In this drive by the Choctaws.
I will say it is tough for the backup quarterback to come in a situation like this. You've been on the bench all game long. And the offense just changes almost wholesale. Right, you know.
I mean, we immediately saw as soon as John Henry came out, they went from having two split backs with a in the pistol with a fullback right behind him to four receivers and a single back. And they've passed the ball every single time. It's just a completely different offense. And to their credit, these receivers have gotten open, and Davis has gotten the ball to his receivers for the most part. Just got to convert.
Ben Pledger still warming up on the Choctaw sideline. If he gets a chance to come in and kick and tie the game. 3-point West Georgia lead with a minute 8 to play. It's 4th and 6. Line of game for the first down is the 41 of West Georgia. This could be the ball game right here. Davis sends three wide to the left, one to the right. Quick drop back. Gonna
He's
throw
got a
back
man.
Foot. Got a man open wide, left side. It's caught by Williams along the far sideline. It's a first down to the 37. Clock stops, 59 seconds to play.
And that's really close to field goal range for Pledger, too.
From here, it'll be 54. Needed a little closer. First and 10. Two right, one left. Davis takes the snap. Looking right, throwing. Williams makes the catch. Needs to shake his man. Out to the 35. Down to the 31. Strong run after the catch from Marcus. Clock rolls. 47 seconds to play. One timeout remaining for MC.
Clock's going to continue to tick. I think we're going to see maybe one or two plays out of this offense before they put it in the foot of Ben Pledger.
Crowd saying go, go, down to 30 seconds. Second down 4 for the Choctaws. Here comes the pressure. Davis throwing for the end zone. Way too long and incomplete intended for Batiste. From here, it's a 48-yard attempt for Ben Pledger. And by the way, you look down way on the other side on the Choctaw sideline on the south end of the field. Ben Pledger all alone kicking the football into the net. Nobody talks to the kicker.
Everybody says kickers are head cases. In this situation, you leave him to himself and let him Let him get in his zone.
Third and four, 20 seconds to play. Davis takes the snap. Gonna throw, got a man there, left sideline, just past the outstretched arms of Mekhi'l Franklin. Oh my.
Franklin needed one more step, and that's a touchdown.
Fourth and four. Pledger's ready to go if needed.
Choctaw offense saying John they want to stay on the field.
But yeah, he's not convinced.
I don't think they'll let him.
They're going to let him kick. Yeah, timeout Choctaws. And Pledger's going to come on to try to tie it, send it to overtime.
You know, speaking of the new rules in college football this year, I guess it doesn't matter because West Georgia's only got one timeout. But I was going to say, I would anticipate they try to ice the kick.
You can do it once, but you can't do it more than that.
They've only got one timeout anyway. I don't know. Actually, do you think they try to let the kick go and maybe try to save the timeout to have two plays to try?
Yeah, I don't think there's any reason to call the timeout here. Line of scrimmage, the 31. Near hash. No breeze.
It's going to be a 49-yard field goal.
Would be a career long for the sophomore from Jackson, Tennessee. 2 of 2 this season, hit a 46-yarder against Kaiser, which was the longest field goal made since 2015 by a Choctaw kicker. This would be even longer than that. 49 yards, right hash. Andrew Studer is the long snapper. Houston Smith, the backup punter, is the holder. The snap, the kick, timeout
is
called.
Him. But they that kick, he nailed it.
He nailed it, but they called timeout.
Just got to let that one build confidence.
I'll say this. The last maybe 3 or 4 years, the Choctaws haven't had an option at kicker.
No.
2 years ago, the Choctaws did not attempt a field goal until week 8 of the regular season.
And if you remember that same season, the Choctaws needed about a 25, 30-yard field goal to win against Delta State, and they couldn't get it. Ben Pledger has been a game changer for this team.
Yes. So West Georgia just burned their last timeout. All right, here we go again. Pledger for the tie. 49 yards, right hash, no breeze. To tie it at 38. The snap, the hold, the kick is away. It has the distance. It is good. No, no good. He called it no good. Off to the right. No good. Off to the right, just a hair. I saw one referee start to put his arms up. And the signal then is no good. Just off to the right. So 10 seconds to play in the game, and West Georgia will hang on and win it 38-35.
Hey, no, NDS, NDS, get out, let's go, NDS.
That was about as close as it could have been.
Yes. From our standpoint, it went just to the right, to the outside of the right upright. And that's it. Man, this hurts.
Yeah.
Hurts for these guys in blue and gold tonight. 38-35, West Georgia. That's the final. We'll take a timeout. We'll come back and wrap it all up when Choctaw's football continues in a moment.
CED Tupelo, your local electrical distributor. At CED Tupelo, practicing our company. We'll be right back.
There was a time when a person's word was enough. A time when a handshake meant something and integrity really mattered. For over 70 years, the values of Farm Bureau Insurance have been rooted in hard work, faith, and family. In that time, we've seen the world change in many ways. What hasn't wavered is Farm Bureau Insurance's commitment to our customers to protect their way of life and serve the communities in which they live when they need us most. You deserve more. You deserve a promise.
A heartbreaking loss for Mississippi College here tonight and an outstanding comeback win for West Georgia. 38-35 is the final score. 21-17 at the half was the score. MC had the lead by four. In the second half, West Georgia got a 14-yard touchdown run from their quarterback, Cameron Brown. That made it, after a nine-play, 86-yard drive, that made it 24-21 West Georgia. Choctaws got the lead back, 2:55 to play in the third, 28-24 on a 10-yard run by John Henry White. And then Ron Creighton scored at 10:13 to play in the fourth quarter on a 12-yard run. That made it 35-24. West Georgia answered within a minute and a half. Terrell Cole caught a 57-yard touchdown pass. And that made it, I'm losing track of the numbers there, but that is what gave them the lead. And they go on to win 38-35 as Ben Pledger's kick at the end falls a little off to the right. And again, I'm watching the kick. I always watch the officials because from my angle, it's tough to tell sometimes whether the ball goes through the uprights. The official on the near side started to put his hands up and then waved it no good. So from good to no good, and the Choctaws take the loss. They're 1-2 on the season. The Wolves are 2-1. What a great ball game here tonight. Full wrap-up available on GoChoctaws.com, and you can read the full story at blueandgoldmc.com tomorrow. So West Georgia next week takes to the road to take on the University of West Florida. West Florida lost tonight to Florida A&M 31-10. Delta State beat Valley State 35-7. North Greenville beat West Alabama 23-16. And Valdosta beat Kaiser 49-25. Choctaws Football is a production of Blue and Gold Sports at Mississippi College in cooperation with the Mississippi College Department of Communication, offering undergraduate degrees in digital media production, interpersonal and public communication, journalism, ministry communication, media analytics, public relations, and sports media, plus graduate degrees offered online. For more information, visit communication.mc.edu. Our next broadcast of Choctaws football is next Saturday. Choctaws visit the West Alabama Tigers. Kickoff is scheduled for 6 p.m. Our pregame show will begin at 5:45, and you can listen live at GoChoctaws.com. My thanks to our entire Blue and Gold sports media crew, our senior producers, Avery Dugan, our producer tonight, Jay Seaman, our director, Evan Brown, and everybody else. Thanks so much for your great work, including Brenton Crosby, Madison Dean, back in the studio, and our outstanding camera operators here at Robinson-Hale Stadium. Once again, our final score, West Georgia 38, Mississippi College 35. For Charlie Williams, Zach Sewell, our entire Blue and Gold sports crew, I'm Reed Vance saying thanks for joining us for Mississippi College Choctaws football.